Hey, I'm Cameron, and today I'm looking at fixing accessibility issues in React code using eslint and large language models. I've set up a file with some accessibility issues in React, and here's what that looks like. I've got a div with an onclick handler with the label button. Presumably this onclick handler just console logs something, but presumably it's meant to approximate a button. This is a problem, and we dutifully get a warning from the ESLint plugin JSX-A11Y. This is a popular plugin for React accessibility linting. And I've modified this plugin so that when we try to fix the error, it will provide an approximation of a fix for educational purposes. So if I run eslint dash dash fix on the file, and I look at the changes, what I see in place of the div onclick is div roll button tab index 0, onclick is still there, onkey press, with a callback that checks for enter a space key and calls onclick. This is actually close to correct. There's an error here, there's a syntax error here, which is where expected one arguments. Yes, onClick should be called with the event. Keyboard event, argument type keyboard event. So in any event, there's a little bit of diagnostics to do on the typing, but and in this case, it's because the strict typing on event for a keyboard event is going to be incompatible with the click event, mouse event here. This is really cool though, because we're seeing a couple of compelling results. We've added an accessible role via aria role. We've added a tab index of 0. We've got it on key press for enter in space. This is technically correct. It's a little squirrely in places. I would use event.code here and change that to space, etc. But it's not bad, and it actually illustrates the outcomes that we, or the approaches that we want. I think having this kind of LLM approach to ESLint fixes for both accessibility and outside of accessibility is kind of compelling, at least just for an educational purposes. That's it for today.